the 6th of November. It's around 10:30. What are we up to today, Josh?
So this is our first camping trip with our new pup, Dudley. So we had to pick, obviously, campsites that we could bring dogs to, which was a little bit different. We decided, with being so close to Corryong, we're not exploring any of it yet, that we'd head up this way. So we're pretty much just winging the whole weekend. We've got a kind of an idea of where we want to head, but we're just going to, if I don't know, if we see something, we'll pull off, and we don't know where we'll end up tonight or anything like that. The plan is to sort of search around Corryong and then make our way to Benambra, and then into Omeo and then back from Omeo. So I don't know, we'll see how far we get. But we camped at Indy Bridge last night, which was pretty cool. Nice, like, open green paddock, which was real good. And then we've just come down to Bunroy Creek, and now we're just heading out of that now. We're going to head down to, there's a Jack Riley Memorial down the bottom that's meant to be pretty cool. So we'll head across down to there and then try to do some tracks across and back up to Corryong. So, yeah, we'll just see where we end up.
Awesome.
So it's now 6 o'clock on the Saturday night. We just pulled up camp, had a bite to eat, and what did we do today, Chloe?
Yeah, so this morning we woke up at Indy Bridge Campground, and our plan for the day was to go check out the Jack Riley Memorial, which is the original man from Snow River. So yeah, we headed out, had a look at Bunroy Creek, and as well as our Hairpin Bend. And the tracks didn't really work out as we'd planned, a lot were closed, so we decided, after checking out the memorial, which was really cool, that we'd head back through. We hadn't done the road from Corryong to Benambra, so we decided that we'd do that, and then that way we're closer to Omeo and Lake Dartmouth for tomorrow morning, because we haven't done all the tracks around there that we've wanted to do. So we just started that road, and then we decided we'd check out a few campgrounds, and a few of us are a bit undecisive about which campgrounds we want to stay at, so we visited a few before we finally settled on the Gibbo Hut Remains campground. So yeah, so we've just had dinner, and Dudley's playing with his toys, and he did a very good first day in the troopy. So yeah, that was our Saturday.
Your sheep, chauffeur, take you where you wanna go. Get you there now, see. tries to be like us, but some things they could never be. Cause we will never turn our hearts away. You and I will be your friend all my life. If I lose my way, I'll be fine. Cause you won't let me go, you won't let me go, you won't let me turn our hearts away. Just like Coldplay, you will fix me when I'm down at a low. No more guessing where we fit in, cause we know where to go. Everybody wants to know what different really means, and everybody tries to be like us, but some things they could never be. We will never turn our hearts away. You and I will be your friend all my life. If I lose my way, I'll be fine. Cause you won't let me go, you won't let me go, you won't let me turn our hearts away. You and I will be your friend all my life. If I lose my way, I'll be fine. Cause you won't let me go, you won't let me go.
So we didn't get to do an outro for this this trip or this video, so we're just sort of at home now doing it. But we've pretty much pulled this trip from a recent book that we found online about the high country. So here's a picture of that now. And then just to give you the, we kind of joined a few of the tracks together to make this trip or put this trip together. So these are the ones we put together. So we pretty much, we booted it all the way to Corryong. And then we followed this road down. We camped at Indy Bridge, that's where we camped the first night. Came down here, had a look at Bunroy Creek and Hairpin Bend, and then came down, and our end point was this Jack Riley Memorial here in at Surveyors Creek. Our plan was originally, we were gonna head back along this this track here and all the way back up into Corryong. However, this the track joining these two roads were closed. So we pretty much just had to detour all the way back and back the way we came. So that was the first sort of trip that we did. We then linked in with this second trip. So as you can see, Corryong's up at the top there. So we came back into Corryong. Now we didn't actually come down on this yellow road like they suggested. We'd actually done that before in a previous trip. So we thought instead we'll stay on the actual main Corryong to Benambra road, which was really cool. There's just heaps of awesome campsites through here. There were some awesome views. There was some really good views of Bogong along the way.
And we actually ended up camping at this Gibbo Hut ruins down here, which was pretty cool. And then the last trip that we did, so we came all the way into Benambra and we went around Lake Omeo and then across. And this was the last trip that we joined in. So as you can see, it says to Benambra there. So we were just out here. We came across under Lake Omeo and this joining road here was really, really cool. Had some awesome views of just green rolling hills. And then, yeah, we just missed this first bit. We started at this Kinamunji Bridge, which was really cool. Awesome campsite there, dog friendly. It's like a green paddock, pretty much, along the Mitamita River. Really, really cool. And then you come up, and you pretty much all you do is you follow the Mitamita River all the way up until you sort of get into this denser forest. So we got to this junction here. And then we saw, obviously we had the book with us, so we saw this Kennedy's Hut and Taylor's Crossing, so we thought we'd head in and have a look. They were really, really cool. You'll see in the videos, obviously, but Kennedy's Hut was awesome. It overlooked the Mitamita River. Was on a bit of a perch. Nice green grass around. The hut had heaps of character. So that was awesome. Actually one of my favourites. And then Taylor's Crossing, we came all the way down here. The crossing was crazy high, so we were never going to attempt to cross it. It was actually open still, I don't know how, but they had an awesome bridge to walk across, so we had a look there. Really, really cool. And we pretty much just came into this Wombat PO Hut. I think it's PO means post office, but I'm not actually too sure. Our plan was to follow this track all the way back out along this, what is it, Holloway's Log Road. However, when we were there, we were talking to a few of the campers there who had come in the night before, and they recommended this Lightning Creek track, and we're so thankful they did because it was awesome. So we headed up here out of this Wombat Hut, head up this Wombat Creek track. It's very, very steep. It's got like a nice rocky base, but still very, very steep. So that was heaps of fun. And then we got up to the top, some nice views, head along this ridge line here. And then we dropped down onto this Lightning Creek track here, which was a grouse way to finish. It had, what did we count? 13, I think there was 13 or 14 creek crossings. You pretty much just cross the creek, loop up, cross the creek again, loop up, cross the creek. It was awesome, very, very cool, and not too hard at all. And then we pretty much came out to the, I think it's the, is it the Lightning Creek Reserve? I'm pretty sure it's in there. And then we just pulled up there, had some lunch, aired up, and then that was pretty much the end of the trip. Then we just booted it back up to Mitamita home. Definitely recommend this book. It was really, really cool. We thought we'd done a lot of the trips in here, but we still got it just in case we could do or get a few ideas out of it. It was awesome. We ended up linking these three together. And it was such a cool trip. And it worked out really well. So, woo.